Hey guys, Janik here for Cinecom.net, and apparently you like Jill's dancing. So we were thinking, and hear me out, maybe we combine Jill's dancing with Premiere Pro effects and neon lighting.
So pretty!
And we are in luck. Chris Brown and Young Thug just made a new music video called Go Crazy, and they have a neon dance effect in there. How coincidental is that? So let's recreate this effect and launch Premiere Pro. Now in Premiere Pro you can drop your footage into a new sequence. And you are probably wondering what footage you need. Well, for this effect we need our dancer separately, so you have three options. You just shoot your dancer where you want and you rotoscope him out with the awesome new rotoscope tool from After Effects.
Wow!
And if you want to know more about this rotoscope tool, we just made a video about it and you'll find a link to it in the description below. A second option is working with a dark background while your actor is well lit. Then you can use the Luma Matte effect in Premiere Pro and single out your dancer. Of course, this technique won't always work that good. So we are going to use the third option, which is a green screen. Okay, let's rewind. So we have our green screen shot in our sequence, and of course we also have a clean plate underneath it. Now let's use the Ultra Key effect and make the green magically disappear. Look at that! Jill is already dancing in our hall. Next, we are going to add multiple effects to the dancer clip to create the outline of our dancer. But first, we need to duplicate our keyed out dancer to the top, and you can disable the layer for now. Then let's start with the effects. The first one is the defined edges effect, and you can drag that to your middle dancer clip. The only thing you now need to do is enable the invert button. The next effect is going to be the alpha glow effect. Again, drag it to the middle dancer clip. Here you can decrease the glow to around 10 and disable the fade out. The third effect is going to be the extract effect and will remove the weird purple look and make everything black and white. Here you can increase the black and white input a bunch until you have something like this here. Now we are getting there, but we still need more effects.
One more appliance could overload the system.
However, before we overload the Adobe system, I would like to overload your brain with the most awesome stock video website ever. Our sponsor, Storyblocks Video. With their ever expanding library of 4K and HD stock clips, you will always find something you need for a project. That's why I can't say enough that Storyblocks Video is a filmmaker's best friend. It helped us numerous times with finishing a project when we didn't have the proper shots, because sometimes you just can't film certain things, like underwater shots, or drone shots of mountains, and even a rocket launching. Not the most everyday shots, but we still need them. And what we also need are easy to customize After Effects templates and super awesome motion design assets, because saving time on a project is priceless. And that's where Storyblocks Video comes in with their huge library. And the best thing about Storyblocks Video is that you only need to pay one single price per year for unlimited downloads.
Shut up and take my money!
So, if you want to start downloading right away, go to the first link in the description below. Let's continue with making an awesome neon dance effect. Select your middle dancer clip, right click on it and choose nest. Now go into that nested sequence and here we can add some more effects. First, let's duplicate the clip. Then we will use a new duplicate as a track mat. This way we will end up with only the outlines of our dancer. So take the track mat key effect and drag that to the bottom dancer clip. In the settings, set the mat to video 2 and the composite to matte luma. Now of course with everything being black in the background, you won't see any difference.
Duh.
So to show you what we are doing, let's place a red background behind it. Note, you don't need to do this. This is just to show you the results of the track mat. So as you can see, the track mat will remove the inner black part of your dancer. Let's remove our red background and go back to the main sequence. First things first, enable the dancer clip on top and move it to track number 8.
What did you say?
Yeah, you heard me. Track number 8. Then take the nested sequence and move it to track number 7. You also need to offset it a few frames to the right. Now the outlines will be delayed and follow the dancer. Next up will be the color and the glow. Take the tint effect from the effects library and drag it to your nested sequence. Now map the white to the color you want, then the next step will be the glow. Look for the VR glow effect and again drag it to your nested sequence. In the VR glow properties, you can start with changing some settings. First, lower the luma threshold to 0, then also decrease the glow radius a bunch, and next up, increase both the glow brightness and the saturation to 10. This will leave you with a nice glow. However, personally, I find the glow too hard. That's why I made a duplicate of the nested sequence underneath the original nested sequence. Then I added a Gaussian blur to that new duplicate and blurred it a whole bunch. Also decreased the opacity to around 30 or 40. There is still something missing. We need multiple neon outlines. So select the finished outlines we already have and duplicate them to track number 4 and 5. Again, offset them with a couple of frames, and in the tint settings you can change the color. Of course, change the colors for both duplicates. Now duplicate the outlines one more time, again offset them and change the color. And now we are done! It is time for Janek's Fun Fact Fountain! Did you know that real neon lighting was invented as early as 1902? But the first commercial neon lights in America were used in 1920 and they cost around $12,000. That's a lot of money for that time. And another fun fact about neon as a gas this time. Well, it's used to freeze corpses, and not in a creepy way. No, neon gas is used for cryonics. This means they freeze people so that they are preserved in the hope that they can be revived in the future. So in other words, every sci-fi movie was right, maybe. And that was it for today, guys. By the way, what do you think about the new editing style? Yay or nay? Thank you so much for watching. Thank you Storyblocks Video for the support. And like always, stay creative.
It's super simple. First we go 1, 2, 3, and 4. It's that easy. Here we go. Your turn now.